prepared with our Kleenexes on both sides. We're ready to go. Dearly beloved, both gathered in this room and around the world on Facebook, we're gathered in the presence of God to witness the joining of Gustavo and Annette in the holy estate of matrimony. Marriage was instituted by God in the Garden of Eden. And as we know, it was at a wedding where Jesus chose to do his very first miracle, turning something so ordinary like water into something extraordinary and special like wine. Marriage was God's idea, but it's when he is part of the union that it becomes a blessed thing. And so we take time to invite him now in prayer to be part of this ceremony. Father, thank you for bringing Gus and Annette together in this place. Thank you for bringing them together in life. And Lord, you have chosen to knit their hearts together over courtship, and now you're going to be knitting their souls together in wedlock. Father, we pray that you would be glorified in this celebration, and you would be glorified in their lives. We thank you for all that you've done for each of them in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the book of Genesis, it's interesting that it's God and not Adam that said it's not good that men should be alone. So the Lord said, I'll make him a helper, an aid comparable to himself. And we talked about some of these things in our time together beforehand, but let's review some of these things now. Gus and Annette, that means that you guys are going to be helpers to one another. You can come a little closer, Gus. That's all right. There we go. You're going to be helpmates for one another. You're going to aid one another. You're going to be teammates together in everything that you do. And so for today, this means that, Gus, you're going to help Annette be the very best wife, the best woman, the best Christian that she can be. And Annette, likewise, you're going to help Gus be the very, very best man, husband, the man that God created him to be. You're going to help him be that. Again, you're going to help each other be whom God created you guys to be. And to do this, you need to follow God's guidelines as they're written in the Bible, and I want to read from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 through 33. And we spoke about this before, but to be reminded of the scripture, it says this: wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as also Christ is head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother, be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each one of you, in particular, so love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. Now, Gus and Annette, before we go anywhere else, we need to remember that this scripture that we read and that we talked about before speaks first of Jesus's relationship to the church, the love that Jesus has for us and our relationship back to him. That's the model, and that's the standard for all biblical marriages. And if you guys both keep your eyes on him and you seek to honor him first and foremost in your marriage, everything else is going to follow. And so, in regards to how this applies to us, Gus, as a husband, this puts a tremendous responsibility on your shoulders. God's word says to all husbands that you're to be the head of the wife. So you're leading her, you're protecting her, you're providing for her, you're leading your whole household in the things of God. And you're to love Annette the way Christ loved the church and gave himself for the church. He gave everything for the church. You're to give everything for Annette, second only to your love for God himself. So convince her of your love. Make her feel secure and your love for her. Later in the Bible, 1 Peter says that you're to dwell with your wife with all understanding. So you don't lord over her, but you communicate with her. You try to seek to understand her, treat her as the precious jewel that God has entrusted her to you as. And again, 1 Peter says you give honor to her as a weaker vessel. So you value her, you protect her, you recognize her, you compliment her. And then back in Ephesians, of course, it says you sanctify and cleanse her in the water of the word of God. That's what Jesus does with the church, and that's what we're to do with our wives. You're to set apart time in the Word, because the Word is going to be what cleanses her. You can't ever change Annette. God's Word can, and that's what you want to have happen, because you're going to be presenting her back. Just like we're presented back to God as a church, you're going to be presenting Annette back to God as a glorious wife. You are a steward, and you're to take that stewardship responsibly. Annette is a wife. You're to submit to your husband as unto Christ. So you willingly follow his leadership. You support him. You encourage him. Wives never understand how powerful their impact is. Your influence is so very great. Cherish that responsibility. Of course, you're to respect him. Submit to him in a respectful way. Value him as a man. Respond to him in love. And just like he convinces you of his love for you, you're to convince him of your love for him. And of course, if the two of you do your parts, you can be sure that God will do his part. He'll be the bonding element in your marriage, causing the two of you to be one, tightly knit, bound together in his love. All right. So I'm going to ask you some questions. And if this is your intent, please say, I do. Gus, do you agree before God and these witnesses to take Annette as your lawfully wedded wife, to love and cherish her, to honor and to cleave to her, to provide for her both physically and spiritually, to pray for and encourage her in the ways of God, to live together as joint heirs of God's grace, forsaking all others, to keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live? That's your intent. Say, I do.
I do.
And Annette, do you in like manner agree before God and these witnesses to take Gus as your lawfully wedded husband, to love him, to cherish him, to submit to him, to respect him, to honor him and help him, to live with him in all faith and tenderness, forsaking all others, to keep yourself only unto him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
You do. Wonderful. Well, facing one another, you may join hands and repeat after me. Gus, you first. I, Gus, do take you, Annette.
I, Gus, I take you, Annette.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully
wedded wife.
Wedded wife.
And I do promise.
And I do promise.
And covenant.
And covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving, faithful husband.
To be you.
Loving.
Loving.
Faithful.
Faithful.
Husband.
Husband.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
According to God's plan.
According to God's plan.
As long as we both shall live. As long.
As long.
As we both shall live.
As we both.
Shall live.
Shall live.
Annette, repeat after me. I, Annette, do take you, Gus.
I, Annette, do take you, Gus.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
And I do promise.
And I do promise.
And covenant.
And covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving, faithful wife.
To be your loving, faithful wife.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
According to God's plan.
According to God's plan.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
At this point, I would ask if you have rings, but I know exactly that you have rings because they're right behind you. Rings are a remembering symbol. They're made of precious metal to remind you of your precious love for one another. Each ring, of course, is a circle that never ends, to remind you that your love and your commitment for another never ends. And Gus, would you take the ring for Annette, place it on her finger, And repeat after me. Annette, with this ring.
Annette, with this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And give you.
And give you.
In token.
In token.
And pledge.
And pledge.
Of our constant faith.
And our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
And Annette, would you take the ring and place it on Gus's finger and repeat after me? Gus, with this ring, I thee wed.
Gus, with this ring, I thee wed.
And give you in token and in pledge.
And give you in token and in pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
At this point, we get to celebrate communion, or you do as well. It's significant that, I can say this to the phone, I suppose, that the first thing Gus and Annette have chosen to do together is celebrate communion. It's a symbol of bringing Christ into their marriage. It's a symbol of the two of them becoming one, like we have become one with Christ. He is making you two one. Communion is a time to remember the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. It's a time to remember that in doing this, he has saved us from our sins. I want to read to you from 1 Corinthians 11, starting in verse 23. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. We'll take the bread. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for Jesus, that his body was broken for us. Thank you, Lord, that he became the substitute sacrifice for us, that Lamb of God that was slain. Thank you that he died for Gus and Annette, paying the price for their sins. And they remember as they partake of the bread in Jesus' name. Amen. And cup. Father, thank you so much for allowing your Son to have his blood shed for all of us, for Gus and Annette. Lord, there is no more precious item in the universe than that of the blood of Christ. Yet he willingly shed it for them, that their sins could be forever forgiven. So, Lord, we thank you for doing so. We partake in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray. Father, what a blessing it is to be here to celebrate how you have joined these two together. Thank you, Lord, for introducing them to one another, letting them gain a friendship, letting them gain a romance, a love, and now, Lord, you have before them a lifetime of marriage. What a wonderful gift you are providing to them. Join them together, Lord, physically. Knit their families together spiritually. Provide for them financially. Help them form a God-honoring home, one that gives you glory in everything that they do. Help them know Jesus more and more every day as they grow in their love for you as well as for each other. And thank you, Lord, again for the work of Jesus on their behalf, that he died for them, rose from the grave, so their sins can be forgiven, they can be made your children. And now, Lord, you've made them one. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So by the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I declare to you, Gustavo, and to you, Annette, you are now husband and wife according to the ordinance of God. Mark 10:9 says, therefore, what God has joined together, let not men separate. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And now, you may kiss your bride. Praise the Lord. Well, turn and face the camera. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Gustavo and Annette Garcia. Praise the Lord.